Hello guys, welcome to Practice House, and here you can find a lot of practices and example programs for your personal practice and for your own project. So here you can learn so many things. So today we will learn how to design HTML5 input type that's called range. So here you can see there is a small slider that can be customly designed with a nicely running track and with a thumb. So how to design this kind of such a nice things? Let's we start doing our code. Okay, so here I have a small folder. I have a folder called ph, and inside this folder I have a file called input.html, and we are going to edit with our Sublime text editor. So this is our input.html file, and it has a nice HTML5 syntax. So inside the body, we are going to take a input. The type is range, and it has a minimum value, and this one is 0, and it has also maximum value that's called 100, and also it has a state, and state is it is step 10 by 10. And it has a default value, and default value we are putting 0. And now it's a self-closing tag, so it's close here. And now let's run in our browser. So here is the Google Chrome, and you can see the things is here, but it's not nice because it has a default style. So okay, so we are using an inline CSS here. And we are just putting a style tag with a width property that the value is 800 pixel. Okay, so now you check it is a. And now you check it, you can see this 800 pixel long. Okay, now we need to design these things. So we are going to use internal CSS. So here I am taking a style tag and closing the style tag. Inside this style tag, I need to design this input type. So first of all, before designing this one, we need to remove the default design first. So what is our input? Then this one has a type, and type is range. So we are targeting our input type that is range. And this one, okay, I indent is for your, okay, I indent it. So we have an input, the type is range. So what we will do webkit appearance. The webkit appearance none. So we are going to hide these things totally, and we'll fix the width is 100%, and the background is transparent. So in the same thing, we will focus our in a thumb. So we just input type range, and we will target this slider thumb. And we'll just say WebKit appearance is null, and also we will remove the blue border. So okay, I'm copying and pasting here because it's too many lines. If I'm going to write this one by one, it will take a long time. So here, so now you check in your browser, you can't see these things. It's already removed. So you can get nothing here. So your slider is totally hide now. The appearance is none. So now we are going to design the crack. So we will design the crack. So how to design this crack? We will design our crack. So for designing our tag, we will target our input type equals to range, and then we will target this WebKit slider, runable track. And inside this, we will use simple code, okay, like this, that it has a width is 100%, the cursor is pointer, height is 15 pixels, and the background is purple, and the border radius is 8 pixels. So let's check it out in our Google Chrome. Okay, you got your slider with the background color is purple. So in this for these things, so this one is WebKit, is for your Google Chrome and Safari. So for this Mozilla and other all those things, you just copy the same things and you just paste it below there. Either just make it there. So all the documentation will be available in www.practicehouse.com. So you can get all the code there. So you can just copy and paste. Okay. So now if you go and check your slider in a Mozilla Firefox or Internet Explorer or any other browser, it will give the same output. So now we already got our slider. So let's design our thumb. So we just thumb design. So for designing the thumb, what we need to do, we also target same things. It's like input, the type is range and WebKit slider thumb. Then we target these things. And now you just use this kind of code that you can see here, but I'm not going to write because it's too many lines, so it will take my more time. So here you can see the blue color. So here we set the height is 25 pixel and width also 25 pixel. The border radius is 30% and background color is blue. The cursor is pointer. So if we this border radius change to 50%, so you can see that this one is a normal shape. So for Google Chrome and Safari, you need to write it, margin, you have to set the margin top is 5 pixels. So you need to specify a margin in Chrome, but in Firefox and IE, it automated. So you can see now it's in a middle. So if you run, our slider is working with a nice purple background and blue thumb. So if you want to design the thumb, you can do. You just here, let's say height is 20 pixels, but the width is let's say 12 pixels. So how does it look? Just check it out here. It looks like this. If you want to make it more funnier, so you can do 40%. Let's check it here. Okay. So you can change these things. And for Mozilla and other browser, because I am checking in a Google Chrome, so you just do the same thing and just copy and paste and then check. Okay, so we change these things because it's looking very weird. 25 25, and it's 50%, so it looks good, right? The round one. Okay, so here now you can use this kind of code and you can add some cool features like box shadow. Let's say this running track, which has a track here. So if we use a small code like box shadow, you can add this kind of things. We just add here box shadow. So you can see here a small shadow below here is the light gray color. I just add here, you can check this code. Here is the 1 pixel 1 pixel. So you can add so many cool features here, like shadow and the box style. If you don't want this 8 pixel, you can make it 4 pixel, so your border radius will be 4 pixels, so it will looks like more like a bar or something. So here is these things. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and you guys can practice with these things and you can play around with this code, because this code is available in practicehouse.com. And if you like this video, just show me, just click the thumbs up button and show me that you like. And if you have any question, just question below, I will be there. Just comments below, I will be there. And if you want to get the update from my channel, just subscribe it, guys. See you in the next video. Thank you and bye bye.